We've got a quarterback with the talent to be able to do it. Now it's on ownership and Rand Carthen to get a coach in here that's going to maximize Will Levis and allow him to reach his full potential, because I'm not confident that Vrabel and co. can do that.
BWill TFTV, make sure y'all like the video. Make sure you subscribe.
TFTV Sports, BWill here. Just my FanSight after the Titans get drubbed by Houston Texans 26-3. And it's just same old BS, man. I mean, it's just offense wasn't good enough. Defense played pretty decent. It's just protection. You know, name of the game is protection. We had, I think, 5 out of the 6 sacks. 6 sacks is a lot to give up as is. 5 out of the 6 sacks came from that left tackle spot. We've got to get help next year in the draft at left tackle. I don't know if that's going to be Ault. I don't know if that's going to be Fashanu. One of them has to come in at left tackle, or we have to sign a left tackle in free agency like Trent Brown. I don't give a damn who it is. We just need a left tackle in here. And it's not just on the left tackle, though. It's on scheme also. To me, Vrabel has to go. You know, I've got a little cousin that works at McDonald's, and he's held more accountable than Mike Vrabel's been held accountable this year. Where is the accountability? Where is the accountability with this coach, with this coaching staff? This O-line coach has been absolutely horrific. Everybody's regressed on the O-line. Skoronski, he's come in highly touted, one of the best linemen in the draft. And I noticed his first year, and linemen don't necessarily do well in their first year, but he has regressed throughout the year. There hasn't even been improvement throughout the year. That's on coaching. At some point, we've got to look at these coaches. I see people saying, let's give Vrabel another year, this, that. No. Championship windows are thin. And I'm not saying we're in a championship window right now, but your championship window, roster building wise, and historically the way it's looked, is when you have a quarterback on a rookie contract. Our rookie contract for our quarterback is 1 year shorter than Houston's with CJ Stroud. We drafted him in the second round. We've only got 4 years. We don't have a year that we can waste with Mike Vrabel and Tim Kelly at the helm calling plays. We do not have it. For the Titans' sake, the franchise's sake, or Levis and his development's sake, we do not have that time. He's got to go. Vrabel has to go. I want him gone now, but at bare minimum, by the end of the season, he needs to be out of here. He just has to. He's done good for this franchise. It's getting closer and closer like it was with Mularkey. He did well, culture-wise. It's about winning at the end of the day, man. I don't give a damn how much your players play with grit if we're losing. I don't give a damn. I want wins. Super Bowl needs to be the aim of this franchise. And right now, it doesn't feel like it is. Even when we were winning, it doesn't feel like it is. Seemed like this franchise was happy and content with just, making it to an AFC championship game or just making it into the playoffs or just winning the division. We need to be fighting for Super Bowls. We've got a quarterback with the talent to be able to do it. Now it's on ownership and Rand Carthen to get a coach in here that's going to maximize Will Levis and allow him to reach his full potential, because I'm not confident that Vrabel and co. can do that. I'm not. Look at C.J. Stroud in Houston. They've got a rookie quarterback in C.J. Stroud, a rookie head coach in D'Amico Ryans, a rookie offensive coordinator in Bobby Slowick, and they're winning. They won 2 games last year, and they've completely turned that franchise around. Look what a year does to a team and a franchise, a fan base. Look what a year's done to us, and look what a year's done to Houston. They made a change at the top. They got a new guy in there, some new blood in there, and they built the team to his needs. They got him his franchise quarterback. They got him a dominant D lineman end in Will Anderson. They built around his team's needs. And his team's needs isn't just play hard-nosed football. It's not like Vrabel is play hard-nosed football, one-score games, get in there and, barely skate out with a win. No. They're walking the ball up and down the field like they did with Slowick. They're doing that while also playing really good defense, but they're not hanging their cap and saying, we're going to establish the run first and we're going to play good defense, old-fashioned football. They're not doing that. And we're trying to do that, trying to play some old 1980s football. Shit ain't working. It's not. So, next week in Jacksonville is going to be really telling. You got to think, if Vrabel would have lost that game in Miami, if Levis and Hopkins wouldn't have put the team on their back, where would we be at right now with Mike Vrabel? Where would we be? Because we're on a 4-game slide now. Jacksonville's coming in. They got to win. So, it's going to be interesting to see. How we perform next year, how he gets guys to buy in after this ass whooping that we face today, man. It's going to be interesting to see. But make sure y'all check out the watch along. It was tough. I'll be honest with you. It was very tough. I appreciate all the support watching it. And, the big drop by Burks, that hurt. And that's really set the tone for the game. The penalties, this team ain't disciplined, sets the tone for the game. That's just what it is. Make sure you like the video, though. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you follow us on socials at TFTV Sports. And we appreciate you for joining, man. Thank you.
BWill TFTV, make sure y'all like the video. Make sure you subscribe. I'm going to give you a button right here or right here. One of the two. Make sure y'all subscribe.